Okay, Mr. G, it's your turn. Actually, you get to go first, so you can put down any word that you want.
Okay, okay.
Start.
Don't rush me. I'm thinking.
Okay.
Is Tajpolt a word?
I'm not telling you.
Wow, you're fun to play with. Okay.
Tajpolt.
Is Jipatolt a word? Jipatolt.
If you can't say it, I'm pretty sure it's not a word.
Okay, you know what? You know what? Mm. That's fine. That's fine. Let's just, let's go with this. Let's go with Pajolt. Pajolt.
Pajolt? I think I'm going to challenge that word.
What?
Yeah.
Pajolt is a word.
Please use it in a sentence.
I just did. Pajolt is a word. That's a sentence.
Oh, my goodness. Mm-hmm. Boys and girls, I'm Pastor Carl. This is Mr. G. Welcome to Kids Church TV.
Let's Pajolt.
It's another great day.
Kids Church TV. Kids Church TV. Learn God's word so we can know all about his love so we can grow. Come on, let's go. Enjoy the show. We want you to come and see Jesus' love for you and me. We're glad you're here to watch Kids Church TV.
Hey there, boys and girls, and welcome to another great day here on Kids Church TV. And by great, I don't mean good or okay or maybe even kind of nice. I mean great day here on Kids Church TV.
Yeah, maybe I can put this right here. Maybe this goes here. Yeah, that looks about right. Yeah, that looks good.
Okay, yeah. Mr. G, what are you working on there?
Oh, well, you see, I had this absolutely incredible idea.
Okay. Okay. Really?
Yep.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Like, you got a great idea.
I got a great idea.
Well, what might that be?
Okay. So follow along with me, right?
Okay. I'm following.
So we have a ton of light switches on Kids Church TV, right? Like all over the place. Light switches everywhere. And we use all those light switches to turn on stuff, right?
Correct. Yep.
Well, I thought it would just be way simpler for all of us if we just have this one giant battery and hooked up all the lights to the giant battery. So now, when we want to turn everything on, instead of having to switch all the different light switches on, instead, we just turn one giant battery on. Pretty genius, right?
I don't think that's exactly how it works,
what?
Though. Like, it's not a bad idea, but I'm not sure that's how it works.
Of course it's how it works. Have you never watched, like, any cartoons before? A big battery always works.
But we're not cartoons. Well, maybe I think you should,
No, wait, don't touch that! Okay.
Okay.
Just don't touch that.
Why not?
Well, yeah, I don't really know, you see. I mean, I just feel like something bad will happen if you do.
Okay, well, let's just go over to the studio, and we'll start with our big idea for today, all right?
Okay, let's just,
be careful, then.
Let's move this very carefully.
Okay,
let's go.
Well, I don't know about you boys and girls, but I think Mr. G is super positive about this idea working. Hey, our big idea for today, boys and girls, drum roll, ready? The Holy Spirit gives power.
Yes, power. I need more power. Let's go right here. That's good. But first, let's practice our memory verse. It's a new one today, boys and girls, so listen carefully. It's from the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8. And it says this, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you."
Okay, it's our first time with the new verse, so how about we say it again so we can practice? Mr. G, can you
read
us?
That is a supercharged idea. Okay, boys and
That's
girls,
good. That's good.
Let's do this together, all right? Acts, chapter 1, verse 8. It says this, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you."
Nicely done. Nicely done.
Thank you very much.
No, not you. The boys and girls.
Oh. Well, the Holy Spirit gives power.
Hmm.
Wow. Well, I mean, I wish my battery would actually start, working so that we could give power to Kids Church TV with just one easy switch. I mean,
I heard, actually, now that I think about it, I heard that our big idea and our memory verse actually talk about something about power.
Well, yeah, but not the kind of power that you're talking about.
Oh, well, what then?
Well, you see, the Holy Spirit is very special. The Holy Spirit is a person, but you can't actually see him. Jesus said that he was going to send the Holy Spirit to be our helper.
Our helper?
Yeah, to help us live the way that God wants us to live. The Holy Spirit helps us to know what we should and shouldn't be doing and saying and thinking and all of those things. The Holy Spirit helps us.
Okay, that's really cool. So the Holy Spirit, the power that the Holy Spirit gives us...
Well, it's the power to know what is right and what is wrong. And not just to know it, but to then actually be able to do it or not do the things that we know we're not supposed to do.
Okay, but how can the Holy Spirit do this? I mean, does he do this for everyone?
Well, he helps everyone who believes in Jesus, and he can do this because he is God. That's why he can do this.
Wow! Yeah. That is absolutely shocking, right? I mean, the Holy Spirit is God. Wow. Okay, well, I just need some time to let that all sink in and figure out what all that means. So why don't we sing right now?
That sounds like a great idea. Okay, boys and girls, wherever you are right now, why don't you stand up with us? Come on, stand up. Don't sit there. You got to stand up. Come on, let's sing to our wonderful God who gives us power through his Holy Spirit. Let's sing together now.
So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Boys and girls, and welcome back to my laboratory. I'm Sophia the scientist, self-taught, and this is my assistant lab rat. How you doing, lab rat? What's that? Oh, Rata. You're watching Ratatouille? I've never heard of it. Anyways, boys and girls, you've come just in time. It's time for my latest and greatest experiment, bouncy eggs. What's that, lab rat? Eggs don't bounce. Oh, just you wait. But first, safety. Got my lab coat, check. Got my lab goggles, check. Got my lab rat, checkity check. Next, the materials for this experiment we need. This, that, and the other thing. All right, check. Time for science. It's finally done! Yippee! Voila! Science! Now let's take a look at what we've got. Okay. Oh man. Wow. Whoa. Wow, look how squishy this is. See that? Yikes. Okay, now we check this out. That's so fun. Wow, Labra, do you see this? What do you mean? What do you mean, what does this have to do with God's big story today? Okay, listen up. Just like the membrane of the egg, which gets stronger over time since it's in the vinegar, we get stronger by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, this doesn't mean we start bouncing around like an egg. That'd be pretty funny though, right, Labrat? Yeah. But the point is that we have the Holy Spirit live with us. We become stronger. We start living more and more in the way that God wants us to. We start doing and saying and thinking things that show how much we love Him, which we aren't able to do on our own. The Holy Spirit gives us the power to continue believing and trusting and loving Jesus, even when it might be hard to do it. We have the Holy Spirit living with us. He gives us the power not to be perfect, but to be more and more like Jesus each and every day. You just gotta love science and helps us see how amazing God's love is for us. Don't you, Labra? Yeah, well, that's all we've got for you today, boys and girls. All this science with eggs has made me awfully hungry. I think I'm gonna make dinner tonight. What? What's that? What do you mean that'll be a first? We gotta go. See you boys and girls later. Bye. Labra, say bye.
Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to our Bible teaching time here on Kids Church TV. Does anyone know who the Holy Spirit is? The Holy Spirit is God. It's the Holy Spirit whom God the Father sends to live with everyone who trusts and loves Jesus. The Holy Spirit gives us wisdom, comfort, and power to love and obey God. The Holy Spirit even talks to the Father for us. How cool is that? In the Old Testament, God's Holy Spirit came to kings and prophets in a special way to help them serve God better. But watch what happens in today's part of God's big story. The day had finally come for Jesus to go back up to heaven. Jesus told his disciples, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all of Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." And when he said these things, as they were looking on, he was lifted up and a cloud took him out of their sight. Man, amazing. The disciples stayed in Jerusalem just as Jesus told them, praising God and waiting for the Holy Spirit. Several days later, as the disciples celebrated the festival of Pentecost, God's Holy Spirit came and changed everything. They heard a sound like a rushing wind. They saw what looked like fire on one another's heads, and they spoke languages that they didn't even know. Other people asked, "What does this mean?" Peter, one of Jesus' disciples, got up and he preached to the crowd and told them the good news about Jesus' death and resurrection. Peter, with the power and help of the Holy Spirit, even explained Bible verses from the past to prove that Jesus had done what God had been promising through God's big story. The Bible says about 3,000 people believed in Jesus that day. Afterwards, the people worshiped God together, and the disciples did many miracles so that more and more people heard the good news, believed in Jesus, and joined the community of believers praising God. The Holy Spirit gave them power to do this and changed everything. For thousands of years, the people of God had waited for the time when God would give His Spirit to all people. They would know God and know how to obey God. This time had finally come. Since that day, all people who put their faith in Jesus receive the Holy Spirit to live with them. God's Holy Spirit leads them, teaches them, and pours love into their hearts. Jesus' death on the cross made the way for you and for me to be in a fixed or permanent relationship with God and receive the Holy Spirit to live with us. Sin had once destroyed our relationship with God, making it so that we couldn't be near God anymore. But Jesus' death healed this relationship so completely that not only can we be in God's presence, but also God's Holy Spirit actually comes and lives with us. When God's Holy Spirit came, He changed everything, and He changes everything about the way you and I live today. we can know that God is always with us. We can talk to him anytime, and we can turn to him as our helper, comforter, teacher, guide, friend, and the one who gives us power. When God sent his Holy Spirit to earth, he changed everything. When we have faith in Jesus, all people can experience the joy of the God of the universe giving them power. And because God lives with us, we are never alone. When we need comfort because we're scared, God is there. When we need help about how to deal with a confusing situation, God is there. When we need love, listen, God is there. We can talk to God anytime because of the power of the Holy Spirit. We don't need to have our mom or dad or our pastor talk to God for us. No, he's right there waiting for us to talk to him. And we can know the Holy Spirit is always praying to the Father for us. This is such a beautiful truth and a wonderful reason for us to all stand up right now, wherever you are, and sing to Jesus, our Savior, and worship him because he has sent his Holy Spirit to help us love and obey him. So let's stand up and sing right now.
I'm gonna jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Jump to show Jesus just how much I love him. Cause jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. Jump, jump, jump. Jump, jump, jump. Jumping says I love you. I'm gonna dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. Dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. Dance to show Jesus just how much I love him. Cause dancing says I love you. Dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance. Dancing says I love you.
The Holy Spirit really is amazing.
Yeah, he is God, and he comes to live with us. When we believe and love Jesus, he becomes our helper. He gives us power to live our lives the way God wants us to live, and he gives us power to live lives filled with joy and peace and patience and kindness and a whole lot of other great things.
I mean, the Holy Spirit really is powerful, and speaking of powerful, I think I finally got my battery to turn all the lights-o-matic to work. I need you to check this out, right? I just need to do one more thing.
Mr. G, I don't have a good feeling about this.
What do you mean? Just got to attach this last piece right here. That's good. There we go. Okay. Oh,
I am ready.
Ready?
I'm nervous.
Ready?
I'm nervous.
And go! I don't think that was supposed to happen.
Well, that's what happens when you build a battery when you aren't a battery builder, and you build it to turn everything on when everything was already on, my friend.
You make some very good points. So what do we do now?
Let's find someone who can help actually get everything turned back on so we can get to some questions for today.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Pastor Carl?
Yeah, I'm over here.
Are you afraid of the dark?
Okay, make sure your batteries are super duper charged, Pastor Carl. What one question are you extra excited about the boys and girls talking about today?
This week, it's question number 3. Question number 3 says, why do we need the Holy Spirit? Think back to our teaching and what were we learning? Why do we need the Holy Spirit to help us and to be with us? Think about that. Such a good question.
That is a great question. I think I probably would have chosen that question too. Boys and girls, remember, you will talk about that question and more with somebody in your classroom or in your home as soon as we're done here today. Well, I don't know about you, Pastor Carl, but my battery is just empty. Poosh, gone.
Well, I guess that means it's rewind time.
Yeah,
so, boys and girls, our rewind, which some of you already know, is where we rewind the episode for today and point out some of the important things that we've already learned. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, then let's rewind. When God's Holy Spirit came, He changed everything, and He changes everything about the way you and I live today. We can know that God is always with us.
Acts chapter 1, verse 8. And it says this, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you.
Drum roll, ready? The Holy Spirit gives power.
And that's our rewind for today, boys and girls. But before we say bye for now, Pastor Carl, why don't you pray for us and thank God for our time together?
Sounds like a plan. Okay, boys and girls, let's bow our heads and pray. Heavenly Father, God, we love you and thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, so we can be forgiven of sin. And thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to be our helper and to give us the power that we need. Lord, thank you for your Spirit that helps us honor you, obey you, and live for you. We love you and pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. All right, boys and girls. Well, that's all the time we have for today.
We are so thankful that you were able to be with us here and learn about the Holy Spirit and how the Holy Spirit gives us power.
And until we see you again, remember that Jesus loves you.
See you all next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, wow. Oh, my goodness. I could do this for hours. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. I wonder where Labrat went. Gets a little grumpy when he doesn't have a seventh helping of cheese pops in a day. Oh, well. Guess I gotta bounce.